What's the difference in React between server-side rendering and server components? For a while, I had trouble identifying the difference between the two. It kept bothering me. On the surface, both seem very similar. They both happen on the server. They're both intended to render content faster. However, the documentation for server components explains that these two technologies serve different purposes and they operate at different levels. The two concepts are independent. You can have server-side rendering, or SSR, without server components, and server components without SSR. And of course, you can have both together or neither. So how can we understand the difference between the two? The day I understood the difference between the two was when I focused on what is different in the two names, not what is similar. That might sound stupidly obvious, but trust me, it makes sense. Let me explain. We'll go through what each is using a practical example. Let's say we have a to-do app. We have a simple page with a header, the user profile picture in the top right, a side menu, a footer, and the to-do list in the main pane. In React terms, this is a component tree. The main component in this example is the page, which contains the header, the menu, the footer, and the main pane component. The header contains a profile picture component, and the main pane contains the to-do list component, which contains each to-do item component. Now, when Next.js did server-side rendering before Next.js 13, it ran a full version of client-side React on the server. However, it had a very specific entry point, the page component. So in our to-do app example, the whole component tree is rendered to HTML on the server before being sent to the client's browser. Now, this has several advantages. First, the initial load is faster because clients get the entire HTML, so they see a fully rendered page more quickly. Second, it's SEO friendly. Search engines can easily crawl SSR pages, improving the site's SEO. Third, the client-side load is reduced. The server does the heavy lifting, so less work is required from the client-side JavaScript to render the page. Now, there are still drawbacks. You still depend on client-side JavaScript if you want the page to be interactive after that initial render. And that is where server components come in. Because you see, the new thing about server components isn't the server part of the name, it's the component part. Next.js's server-side rendering would take the whole page, the whole component tree, and render it to HTML. This makes it suitable mainly for the initial page load, but less so for subsequent updates on the main page. Server components can each be rendered individually. Now, it's worth noting that they don't output HTML, at least not by default. We'll come back to that outputs format later. First, why is the component, the operative, important part of the name? Why is that important? Well, as Astro's Islands of Interactivity model bangs on, for many use cases, a large part of a web app is static or only has minimal updates. If we look at the to-do app example, the header, the side nav, and the footer parts are static past the initial load. The only dynamic part is the central pane with the to-do elements. React server components means we can add or remove to-do items and only update the part of the component tree that has changed. Server components allow the developers to render specific parts of the UI on the server and then update only those parts as needed. Now, this has a number of cool implications. It means that you can do fine-grained updates with less data transferred because only the components that need to change are updated. There's also less client-side code since components that only run on the server and don't need any server-side code. Data fetching is simpler and they say more rational because server components are each in charge of fetching their own data. Before server components, I would have to fetch all the data in the page component via the get server side props, and then I trickle it down to all the subcomponents. At a high level, SSR is about rendering the initial page, while server components are about dynamically updating specific parts of the UI on the server without reloading the entire page. Now, if you take the time to think about it, there's still a missing piece to the puzzle. We're not rendering all the pages HTML on the server, so how does the browser know how to update just the components HTML? Do you remember how I said that server components don't output HTML by default? The format that React server components output is a streamable text format that looks like bits of JSON. And now, for those of you wondering why they didn't just use JSON, that would be a lot harder to stream. This means that some JavaScript somewhere is deserializing the specific format to HTML. That JavaScript is generic, it's not specific to any given component. Compared to the hydration that Next.js would do before server components, this is a lot more lightweight and targeted. React server components allow us to update targeted interface sections without sacrificing speed or security or SEO, because the interesting word in React server components is components. Now, I hope that makes it clear for you. I know a number of you had questions on this subject. If you still have more questions, feel free to let me know in the comments. And in the meantime, I'll see you in the next video.